Welcome to Sage Audio. Today we're talking about how to mix mid-range. But first, if you have a mix that you need mastered, send it to us at sageaudio.com to receive a free mastered sample of it. Mid-range saturation. In my opinion, the best way to add a lot of power to your mid-range is to use frequency-specific saturation to create harmonics which make your fundamentals more easily perceived. This distortion will make the range sound full and impressive by amplifying in-key aspects of the range. I like using FabFilter Saturn 2 for this, but Trash 2 by iZotope is another good frequency-specific saturation plugin. Let's take a listen. Mid-range upward compression. Using the FabFilter multiband, I can create upward compression by combining the compression setting with a positive range. This means that the quieter aspects of the range being compressed will be captured and amplified from the bottom up. With that in mind, I can isolate my mid-range and create upward compression. Low-level compression creates a very full sound, so use it whenever your mids are sounding weak. Let's take a listen. Subtle mid-range reverb. If the mid-range of a mix bus, stem, or instrument is sounding too separate or like it needs to be blended a bit, use very subtle high-density reverb on your mids. The high number of reflections caused by a high-density setting ties everything together. Again, use this at a lower setting if you're using it on a stem or mix bus, but it can be used more aggressively on an individual instrument. Let's take a listen. Quick mid-range downward compression. If you need to control your mid-range's dynamics, set up a parallel track using a bus or auxiliary send. First insert an EQ with a high and low pass filter, then insert a compressor. Use a quick attack and a medium release, about 100 to 200 milliseconds will work well. This way you can compress the mid-range and significantly control it, then blend that compression back in with the original signal. Let's take a listen. Aggressive mid-range bus. Following the last concept, use the same EQ settings on the auxiliary send, but then introduce aggressive stylistic compression. After that, use a saturator with moderate settings, and lastly, use a low-level compressor. This will isolate the mid-range, distort the mid-range, and then increase the detail. This can sound really intense, so use this if you want a really aggressive mid-range. Let's take a listen. Subtractive EQ on mid-range. If your mid-range is sounding boomy or disharmonious in some way, find out the key of your song and then reference the notes that are being played. For example, if your song is in the key of A major, a C shouldn't be too prevalent. In this case, find the frequency that corresponds to C and attenuate it. Cut these disharmonious notes from your mid-range, but only by about 3 to 6 dB. No need to do it too aggressively. Let's take a listen. Back bouncy mix bus mid-range. On your mix bus, so when you're affecting the full mix, use a multi-band dynamics processor and use upward expansion on the mid-range. Use a quicker attack and then try to time the release with the BPM of the track to give it a bouncy musical feel. I'd recommend doing this by only a couple dB and ensure that the threshold isn't being triggered too often. Let's take a listen. Clear mid-range. The upper edge of the mid-range may need some attention too, since that's where you're going to have the majority of your vocal and clarifying instrumentation. Use a high mid-band or an exciter to add some clarity and detail to this section. Fresh Air by Slate is a good option. Also, Isotope's exciter can be made frequency specific, making it great for adding clarity to the high mids. Let's take a listen. Stereo image, your mid-range. Using a mid-side equalizer, expand the width of the mids by amplifying a side band, or increase the power of the center by using a mid-band. I find that slightly boosting the side low mids in an instrument bus can make the entire mix sound full. Additionally, use this method to pull out details that are being masked, in turn adding more detail to the mix. Let's take a listen. If you have a mix that you need mastered, send it to us at sageaudio.com to receive a free mastered sample of it. Also, join to stay up to date on all of our latest releases. Thank you so much for watching.